Hi, I'm Janet Gervers from JAGmedia. That's my design company. JAGmedia specializes in branding, website design, and graphic design, something I've done for over 25 years. Today, I'm going to help you get started with Canva. It is a great tool, and a lot of people are using it, designers like myself and people that aren't designers. So today, what I want to do is get you started with a simple project, taking a photo that you want to use for social media, it can be a social media post or your website. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is share my screen with you so that you can see what I'm doing. Okay, so hang on here a second. I'm going to hit share screen. And here we go. Okay. So what you're going to see first is this is the Canva homepage. Now you can get an account for free and sign up. You can also get a paid account. What I recommend is you might want to try the free account first, see how you like it, and then get the paid account. It's on a monthly basis. It's very reasonable. So let's just get started right away. Oh, you know what? I should tell you really quick about the paid version of Canva. The things that I do like about it is that you have access to a lot more photos. You have access to different tools like a social media scheduling app, so you can schedule things on Facebook or whatever social media channels you're using, and also resizing individual elements in a project. That's really valuable. And again, like I said, you might want to try it out, the free version, and see how you like it before you do anything. So let's go ahead and look at the purple button that says create a design. That's the easiest way to get started. So it'll show you all of these different things that you can create. And what we're going to start out is with Instagram post. So you see a new window pops open, and I like the size of an Instagram post. It's something that can be used for websites. And what you're seeing right here, I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. If I did it 100%, it's like way big for my tiny screen. So we're just going to have it so it fits right here within the screen. And I'm using this on a Mac interface, so it might be a little bit different on the PC, but overall it should work the same. So first of all, we have a blank white screen. Yay, let's do something to it, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm going over to the left side, and you'll notice this area is open and it says templates, and Canva does have all kinds of templates that you can use, which are great. The thing is you have to go in and customize it really to make your own. So we're gonna start out simply, and what I'm going to do is go close this up. And I'm going to go to this side here on the left, and we are going to click on photos. Canva has a wealth of photos, which is really amazing. And if you want to try to find something, you can just click search, and I encourage you to put some details in there. What I'm going to do simply is I'm going to pick this first photo here. And as you notice, it says pro. So this you can only get if you have the paid version of Canva, but there are a ton of photos that you can use for whatever project you want. So I'm just going to literally drag it over here. And what I'm going to do, I want to fit it in this whole box. So I'm going to take the corner, drag it in here. Now, if you do have the free version, it may not resize as easily as this, just so you know. Okay, so we have this photo here, this woman in a black dress, and this is something be great for fashion website that you could use. And maybe you're like, I like this, but I want the background to be clear. You can do this in Canva. The first thing that you want to do is click right here to duplicate the page. So you have two. I like to do a before and after, and I'm even going to name the title of page one before, page two after. And while I'm doing that, let's name this project. So what you're going to do is go over to File, and you notice it says Untitled Design, and it did also say Instagram, and the size in pixels, 1080 pixels by 1080 pixels, which is square. And you can use this for a lot of purposes, for posting on social media, as well as for websites. And I'm going to name this something custom. We're going to call this Black Dress Tutorial Instagram. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Save to Folder. Now, I have created a folder that's called Tutorials, so it's going to go in there and click Save. That way, it ensures that you know where it is once you come back to Canva, and you can easily find it. I have a ton of folders with a lot of projects, so if you use it a lot, you're going to realize that having a folder and being organized is a really good thing. Okay, so let's close this. So you see the page one before, the page two after. We're not there yet. Be patient. Okay, so we're going to click on this. And as soon as I click on this, you'll see some different options that are up here. Edit the image, you can crop it, flip it, you can add borders, you can even animate it. And the position is for if you have something like maybe text or another photo, and you want one to be on top and one to be on the bottom. This is for a transparent, and this is, I'll just show you what this is. Transparent as if for the whole photo. So you can go from 0 to 100 on that. This is for copying styles, and this is for locking the position of a graphic. What I want to do is I just want to make the background transparent. So what I'm going to do is click on Edit Image. Now, a number of things will come up. And what I'm going to use is, it says BG Remover for background remover. So what I'm going to do is click on that. Okay. And boom, just like that, it removed the sort of peachy orange background, and it's on white. Now, it doesn't look transparent yet, and I'm going to show you how to do that when we save this. And just note over here, you see restore. So if you decided I don't like this, you can restore it. It works best on images that have a solid background. Okay, so here's the before. Here's the after. So let's just go ahead and save both of these images and download them to our desktop. This is really easy to do. So you hit the share button up here, okay? And you're going to scroll down to where it says download. And this is where you click on the file type you want. So for this one, for before, I'm clicking, I call it a JPEG. This is great for photos. It exports them to a size that can load fast for a website or for your socials. Now, so this is the standard, what it has it on, where you see size one. This is actual size, 1080 by 1080 pixels, which you see here. The quality, 80%. This works extremely well in most instances. And now it says select pages. We're actually just going to select the first page. So I'm going to click off of that and click the first page, which is the before. And then I'm just going to click on the download. And you'll see this screen come up. I'm saving this in my tutorials folder that I already made on my computer. So I'm just going to hit save. So we have that. Now, the next thing we're going to do is we are going to click after, and we want to save this with a transparent background. So we're going to go back up to share again. Then we're going to hit download, go to this file type, and we're going to hit the PNG. And that's the extension you'll see on your photo after you download it. So it shows the size. We're going to keep it the same size. We're going to click transparent background. And we are going to select page two, because this is page two. And you can also, if you like, it will give you the option. Let's see, we're going to hit done. Sorry, a little bit ahead of myself. You can click save download settings if you want the same setting for the next time you save another project. So I'm going to click download. And you'll see after.png up here. You see the before that is already saved. It is 61 kilobytes. And the after is at, if you can see up here, 527 kilobytes. So it's considerably larger. Now, the advantage on this having the ping is that you will have a clear background. So I'm going to show you that in a moment. But I want to show you one more thing. Say you want to share this with a client, but you don't want them to log into your account. You just want them to see this. Could be somebody who's a collaborator on your team, etc. So there's two ways you can do it. You can go, we're going to go back to the download, and this is just going to be for this second one. We're doing the same process. And as you see here, there's a public view link. So let's just hit cancel on that. Create public view link. So you see this link down here and you hit copy. And what I'm going to do is open up a new window. I'm going to paste that in. And this is something you can paste into an email. Now, while it does, you'll see that the background looks white here. I'm going to show you another instance of where it looks, where you can tell that it's clear. So this is the first page that we did, and this is the second page. So what I'm going to do is do a new screen share so you can actually see what it looks like. So give me a moment here, and I'm going to click on new share, and I'm just going to show you a preview of the after image. Now you see the background looks gray, and this is opening up in the Mac preview app. So anything in the app that is clear is going to show up as gray. However, if you have it on, say, a website page, it will have a clear background, and it's really useful for a lot of things. So just wanted you to see that. So let's just go back to our project, and I got to click on share again just to make sure that you can see that. So hang on for a second here. We're going back to Canva. Okay, so we've got this again. I'm going to make my screen a little bit bigger. So you see the project here. Now we're going to do something else. We're going to create a completely new project where I'm going to take a photo that I upload from my computer and put it into an Instagram post. So let's go back to home. And you can see up here, there's a home window. And I'm going to go to Instagram post. And I'm going to name it. And we're going to call this, it's a photo upload tutorial. Okay, and I'm going to make sure to save it to the tutorials folder that I created. All right, so let's go to my uploads folder. We're going to close this so it's easier to see. So you have a lot of these things like text on the left side where you can access different things. So this is photos that we used in the very first tutorial. Now in this, what we're going to do is go to my uploads. I can find it. Here we go. Here's uploads. We're going to click that. Now these are ones, these are a bunch of photos that I have already uploaded in the past. It's, if you want to upload a file, you're just going to click upload, and then you're going to browse on your computer to the photo or graphic that you want to add here for a project. So let's say you're like, I want a purple flower. Oh, here's my purple flower photo. You do the same thing you did before. You just drag it into here. And let's make it fill up the entire frame. And you can move things around too. So, okay, so here's my purple flower. And to simply share it, you click share. You can also, once you have it set up, if you want to share it in a post on Instagram or another social media link, you can click one of these. You do have to set it up first. And that'll be another tutorial where I show you how to share on social. So let's just hit download. It's, you know, the same kind of process. We're going to save this as a JPEG. It's better in terms of file size. It'll load quicker. So I'm going to click download. And we can create a public view link, which you saw there in the purple, if you want a client or someone to see that. So I'm going to save it in this folder. And I want you to notice from what I saved before, the after.png is 540K and the before image, which is a JPEG, is 61K. So it's smaller and it will load quicker. However, with the after image there, we want a clear background. So it does have to be a .png format and it is going to be bigger. So let me just correct the name here. So it says tutorial. I'm clicking save. And as you see here, create public view link. I could copy that and I can open a new window and you can see it there. So there we have it. Those are two ways that you can get started on Canva. You can use one of Canva's photos and you can download it to your computer for a social media post or to use on your website or other digital media. You can also upload your own photos and create a project with that. I hope that helps you. I'm Janet Gervers from JAGmedia. You can always see my website at jagmedia.net. That's JAGmedia.net. Thanks, and please like my video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks again. Bye-bye.